In the port of Djibouti, dozens of boxes with MSF or Red Cross stickers, two of the rare international aid organizations still working in Yemen. They're sharing the same boat, as this is the only way to get to Aden, the largest city in the south that has been badly hit by the fighting.
The problem is that Aden Airport has been totally destroyed, so the only way in is by boat. We're lucky to be able to dock, but the port of Aden itself is quite dangerous. Last week, the day before we got there, a boat transporting refugees was sunk.
It's been 3 months since the fighting began. On one side are the Houthi rebels who have taken control of much of the country, and on the other, forces loyal to the president and the Saudi Arabia-led international coalition. A ceasefire agreement signed at the end of May officially lasted 5 days, but the hostilities never really stopped.
We heard the clashes, we heard bombing everywhere, so I don't believe in ceasefire. There is no truce. There is no ceasefires at all.
An MSF team treats the wounded in this hospital in Aden. Every day sees more casualties caused by the fighting that is often very close by.
This patient is a victim of an abdominal gunshot wound. He had severe vascular injuries. He had a gunshot wound through the aorta, and he had severe blood loss and profound shock even before we started resuscitation. Even if we continued for more than an hour with maximum resuscitation, he didn't manage to survive during surgery.
The hospital is working at full capacity, but to reach out to the many people still without access to healthcare, MSF opened a clinic in Crater District.
The people cannot transfer to other area because the way is blocked, and many patients suffer here from injury, gunshot and charbonnel, and receive management here, cannot take access away to other hospitals.
A few days later, an MSF team went to another neighbourhood in Aden, where residents from Crater have taken refuge.
Gunshot where? Left leg. Iman is a displaced place for the people that was in Crater Mualla. Then we decide to come in this place to do 2 times in a week the dressing for patients that need follow-up. But it can reach our hospital, particularly we are for injuring patients during this war.
Sana, Taz, Hamir. Fighting continues across the country, resulting in both direct and indirect victims. Countless people are displaced and bearing the consequences of shortages caused by difficulties in getting supplies through.